जो लोग मुझे जानते हैं और यहाँ कुछ लोग मुझे जानते हैं उनको ये तो मालूम होगा कि टॉपिक मैंने आखिरी वक्त में बदल दिया होगा और उसकी वजह है फॉर मी टू स्टैंड ओवर हेयर एंड टॉक टू 400 पीपल हु आर अमेजिंग प्रोफेशनल्स एंड हु आर अचीवर्स एंड हु एम आई टू टेल देम व्हाट द वर्ल्ड नीड्स फ्रॉम अस. So, before I start to talk about what is my topic, I would like to talk about ke agar mujhe is waqt yahan hamare mere ek ustad maujood hain aur hamare bahut se logon ke ustad hain. Pehle unko hum khalif KZR ke naam se jante the, aaj Kamran bhai kehte hain. To jab career start kiya to unki tarah hum trainer banna chahte the aur us waqt main sochta tha ke जब भी अपनी तकरीर करूंगा तो उसका नाम जो रैम्बलिंग्स हैं उसका एक जेनेरिक नाम रख दूंगा, उसका नाम होगा मेरी जलेबियाँ. एंड एंड इस वेरी केजरा स्टाइल के अंदर, एंड क्योंकि जलेबी मेरा फेवरेट और मेरी बेगम का भी फेवरेट मीठा है और चाहे तो सर्दी में उसको दूध में मिला के खाएं या उसको गर्मी के अंदर खा के उसके अंदर से एनर्जी लें, मगर उसमें ख़ास बात होती है, वो गोल गोल होती हैं. सो एंड सो इफ आई हैड टू हैव फर्स्ट स्लाइड आई वुड हैव मेड माई सेल्फ मेरी जलेबियाँ, मगर हम क्योंकि ट्रेनर ना बन सके और तो इसलिए आपके सामने खड़ा हूँ. सो टॉपिक क्या है मेरा टॉपिक, एंड एन कामरान आई विश आई वुड हैव टेकन माय ऑफर देन. तो जो दुकान मैंने आज खोली वो तकरीबन 10 साल पहले मैं या 15 साल पहले खोल चुका होता. तो कामरान ऑफर्ड मी आफ्टर माय इंटर्नशिप, जब कामरान ने स्टार्ट किया था कि आप काम करोगे, हमने कहा एमएनसी में जाएंगे तो हम नहीं गए. सो आई जस्ट वॉन्टेड टू से गुरु आपके सामने हम खड़े हैं. सो व्हाट्स द टॉपिक. So, my topic, after having heard two hugely from reputable companies all about the fourth industrial revolution, and after that, I have to talk about something which is very personal. This personal, from the point of view, is the dilemma which I'm going through. It's amorphous. After having two phases of life, the first phase 21 saal taleem jo mere case mein zyada thi, nalayak zyada the, and then another 20 years of corporate world, I left the job and I started a company, so called. I bought a bike, I got a tattoo, and I got a beard, and I thought, what's happening? And I realized, oh, मिडिल एज क्राइसिस, एज बढ़ गई, मिडिल एज से भी आगे आ गए. तो दिस समथिंग एल्स व्हाट इज हैपनिंग ओवर हेयर, एंड आई रियलाइज्ड, ओ माय गॉड, आई एम ऑन द थर्ड फेज ऑफ माय लाइफ एंड दैट्स द एंड गेम, एंड व्हाट इज द लेगेसी आई एम गोना लीव, हु आई एम एज अ पर्सन, हु आई एम एज एज समबडी, एंड व्हाट इज माय पर्पस ओवर हेयर इन दिस वर्ल्ड, व्हाई आई एम हेयर इन दिस वर्ल्ड. एंड दिस नेक्स्ट, the whole of my talk is about my personal dilemmas, and that's why I have changed the topic from a systems leadership, that's a big word, and I've recently joined Simon Peter Senjay as one of his students for 3 years, so I wouldn't want to stand here and talk about systems leadership when I've just heard him about 3 months back. So I would simply talk about my dilemmas, my issues, and the way I see the world. So Adil talked about at the start of this conference, those 200 years, this world has totally changed. And that's a huge time, but everybody was talking of the change in 10 years, 20 years. Each one of you can talk about the world was totally different. It was beautiful. Hum aagahi se shuru hote the aur farmane lai se shuru hote the aur basirat tak TV dekhte the. Sadak se bacche nikal ke isi Karachi ke andar ghoomte the. आपके बात किसी भी दुकान के बाहर बैठ के और पान के पास खड़े होकर कॉन्वर्सेशंस वर द मोस्ट ब्यूटीफुल थिंग विच वी यूज्ड टू डू हैव एंड दैट्स इफ यू लुक बैक एंड फटी जीन और गिटार आज भी आपको याद आता होगा. वेरी इंटरेस्टिंग है. सो ईच वन ऑफ यू व्हेन यू लुक वी वर इन ए ब्यूटीफुल वर्ल्ड. द वर्ल्ड समहाउ विद ऑल द ग्रोथ and with all the growth and the highest number, highest GDP ever, 80,000 billion US dollars, and the distance and difference between the haves and haves not is the highest. We have done something wrong here. This world, the whole economy, if you look at the environment, what we have done, we live on this earth, and do you realize in 1980 we were using one earth resources, and in 2018 we are using 1.6 earth resources. So इसी तरह है कि बैंक में आपके पास अपना सेविंग्स पड़ी हैं, आपकी रिटायरमेंट आ गई है और आपकी सेहत भी अच्छी है और आप अपनी सेविंग्स को खाने लग जाएं. And imagine what will happen in 2050 if we have similar population growth rate. We will be somewhere in 2.3 of the earth resources. Excuse me. Magar duniya itni aur insaan to nahi bana isliye ki wo jaan na mare, mehnat na kare, tarakki na kare. 200 saal mein jo usne kiya hai, wo to 2 saal mein karne ko tayar hai. The kind of data which was ever produced till 2013 I was reading, and that's done in 2 years. Every data, now we created, churning out that number. If I'm wrong, please forgive me, because I'm just trying to remember. So we are eating up our resources, and by 2000, and if we grow in terms of technologically, and if we keep growing the way our economy, the world economy is growing, we will be 3.5 times of the world resources. That's what we'll need. So effectively, probably, the millennials will see the price of the lives we lived. And so what does... So in this background, and then now we are in the fourth industrial revolution. And what's happening? We are connected. All the time we are connected. And in this connection, what's happening? Polarization. Human mind doesn't have that luxury of thinking independently. What happened to US? One Facebook, so many people turned everything in that country and the future of this probably world. Now Armageddon or nuclear Armageddon ki baatein economists likh rahe, because of one thing. Technology wrongly used. A technology which has created at a mass level polarization. So, and when you look at individual level, in 80 years, we are at the highest level of depression in the, across the world. In terms of suicide, we are 65% higher than 45 years earlier. And these are some of the numbers, and at a time, when we are all the time connected. Six friends goes to lunch and or dinner, everybody holds a phone and probably send each other pictures. So where does those connections, jo ke jiske liye insaan paida hua hai gaye, where does that chopal ki baatein gayin, wo baithak ghar ke andar baithak hua karti thi jiske andar you need to have, you love to have conversations. Now you have LOL. That's the best way to tell you that probably mujhe badi hansi aayi hai aur ab aap keh ke laga ke dohre nahi hote. And that's kind of the change this is happening in this world, and effectively we have a disconnected population. All of us, even we sit in the same room and husband and wives watch televisions and holding our cell phone, and that's what the other side of technology. And that's what is happening. And so effectively, if you look at this, and then I've not touched one side, is and which I would like to talk about now, is the corporate. Now, BlackRock, I believe, and their CEO came out with the letter to all the CEOs, and he said, Mr. Fink, that now is the consumer and private sector requirement, and then I'm using the private sector as requirement to be conscious of the sustainability, environment, and we need to have a purpose. So organizations are now talking of purpose beyond the bottom line and triple bottom line. However, I have an issue. The same corporate, and then that greed to make lots of money have created us and then made us and then pushed us in the bhatti of hard work, 9 to 5, churning out our pays, and but then the whole environment, the whole world is paying the price. So what do we need? We need a different model. We cannot, yes, we are talking of triple bottom line, we are talking of sustainability, we are talking of social impact. And that's great. But are we doing it out of sheer need of the market because my products will not be sold? Because millennials, 86% of the millennials wants organization to have a social purpose. So you are still doing it, and that's my point of view. And I had a quick WhatsApp discussion with Sir Faraz Rahman, and then those who know, I call him sage of this time. And then he said, and then we were both discussing that, is it coming from the heart, or is it market requirement? And that's why what we need is a different kind of leadership. The leadership which has a, and I, this is 3 minutes, 20 seconds, okay. So what we need is a leadership which has a dream, which has a purpose. And as I said, I was going through the dilemma, and the biggest dilemma for me is, what is my purpose? What is the legacy I want to leave? What is the dream I have? And that's each leader in this new world or a systems world needs to have that vision. And then that vision, that purpose, as they said, that the purpose of life is life of purpose. That purpose has to go beyond. And it has to go much beyond than the bottom line. As there was a strong belief in our HR community that people exist to provide stakeholder value. No, organization exists for the people, not people exist for the organizations. And that belief has to be there. The other thing, it's difficult to define this, is compassion. And compassion for self, because you can't offer compassion to others if you don't have compassion for yourself. And in a world where we created, as HR, we created competencies model where we told them to act smart. We have created that you need to dress up in a certain way and do not bring tears, do not bring too much laughter, do not bring too much friendships at the office. And that's how, what we have done. And when we have done that, so there's no self-compassion. And then how do we expect, if I don't have self-compassion, to have self-compassion for others? So, and then I would strongly recommend Brené Brown. Simon Sinek, definitely a deal. Brené Brown, if I'm not pronouncing it well, go to, and then listen to her, what she says about it on self-compassion. And then, having reflective discussions, where we can sit around fire in a mountain, as you know that I love the mountains, or in a drawing room, or in a boardroom, and talk about, have reflective discussions, much beyond, oh, is saal kitne banayenge, aur agar nahi banayenge, to kitne ko farig karenge. We need, organization needs to think what kind of the whole, what we are doing to the ecology. That's what we need to do. So those reflective discussions are hard. And then bring in the whole self. It's interesting. And then I've written down because they are, we have never talked about the spiritual self in the organization in the true sense of the word. Yes, it has started to come in, but you are a spiritual being in a body. So effectively, let's talk about that. And when we talk of the whole self, and then a book is recently is going to come out on this, which is called Understanding Empathy. So I think I'll definitely recommend that go through it. So let me talk about it. So there are two sides. We have worked a lot. Some of us and most of us is the physical self and inspirational self. But what about the emotional self? What about the community self? What about the intellectual self? What about the mindful self? What about the aspirational self? And all of this together as a spiritual self. And that's where we need to bring in the whole self in the organization. Leaders who look at people and do not look and consider them a resource. The word human resource itself, I think we need, there's something wrong with that. The last, but not the least, and then I wanted to call my discussion about self, community, and the traditional wisdom, but then I thought it will be a very big topic and I won't be able to do justice. And I'm going to use a word here. And the word which we find it very, we think this only be used for the romantic relationships. And I'm going to talk about the word love. How can we bring that word love in the organizations? And I will read in the Rumi's words, your task is not to seek love, but merely to seek and find all the barriers within yourself that you have built against it. Let go. Let go, let go, and let yourself, you have to keep breaking your heart until it opens. And that's, I'll touch love here. And I will end my talk, and then time is up as well, on Confucius and in Chinese thought. And why I've written it over here, because we talk of systems thinking, and so I'm talking of systems leadership, where we want leaders who are reflective, who have purpose, who understands that any effort or anything, any action of theirs affect the whole system. If as a brand manager, I choose a certain packaging, we do understand that packaging will remain in the environment for the longest time. So we need to have leaders who understand this, and I'm going to read it. Heaven is my father and earth is my mother, and even such a small creature as I finds an intimate place in their midst. Therefore, that which fills the universe, I regard as my body, and that which directs the universe, I consider as my nature. All people are my brothers, and all sisters are all, and all things are my companions. So the whole system's thinking in one quote, in a Chinese quote. And I will end. I started that being a leader, being human, and I'm closing again a Chinese quote. And when I sent a message, I was sent a message back that this was a Chinese thought, and I'm finishing it with this. To be a great leader, one needs to be a human first. Thank you very much.